All new tonight at 10 o'clock. School leaders in Pecos are working to right some wrongs, paving a new path to the future. CBS 7's Eddie Garcia is live here in the studio now, giving us a look at the new direction the district is taking. Eddie?
Jay, the interim superintendent and board have their work cut out for them, looking for a new superintendent. They don't deny the position's troubled past, but they say they're using it as a lesson learned.
Luis, this is Maxie.
Interim Superintendent Maxie Watts and the school board are in construction mode, rebuilding a district torn by turbulence.
Bad news travels fast.
News of the very recent ousting of a superintendent is impossible to contain statewide. That's why the district believes it's time to get back to the basics.
I think that somewhere along the line, we've lost sight of the fact that the whole reason we're all here and we all have a job is to make sure that kids have a good educational background.
The search begins internally with qualified candidates.
Before we get down to advertising outside of the district, we will discuss among the board if that is a possibility to bring someone up from inside the district.
I think a cooperation between the entire board in general, as well as the superintendent that we have in place, is going to give us a good foundation to bring in a quality superintendent.
A foundation leaders are trying to build on solid ground.
We're going to bring them a good man here, or woman, whichever the case may be. But at the same time, we're going to continue to be working with the board so that they understand, once you have a good person here, what it takes to keep that person on board.
The interim superintendent tells me he and the board will take part in workshops as part of the process of creating a more stable administration. Live in the studio, Eddie Garcia, CBS 7 News. Jay?
Eddie, thanks very much. We want to highlight some dates of note in the search for the superintendent. On September 3rd, a community meeting will be held to discuss the new superintendent's profile. On October 4th, the position will be publicly posted for statewide applicants. Then on December 6th, the finalists will be announced, allowing the new superintendent to take over by the end of January.